Welcome back once again to another of my tutorial. As you can see, this is what we want to make, how to get our breast ball. That is what I want to make today. And I'm very grateful. I thank you everyone for subscribing. I really appreciate you. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you for everything you have said. Thank you for all your prayers. I thank you for everything. So today I want to show you how to get your breast ball. And as you can see beside me, I have my unwanted fabrics. They have been rejected, so I want to make good use of them. No fabric is a waste or rejected. I want to make good use of them. So these are the balls which I want to make. When making these balls, it's supposed to have smaller one for small balls than for big balls. You can still also have a one bigger than this, for in case you come across a bigger ball. So you need three of these. So what I want to make is I want to make it for a friend of mine, so I decided to drop for you guys to know how I went on to do it. So I want to make similar thing as small as this or bigger than this a bit. So let's go straight into the video. What you need is your masking tape. As you can see, I use masking tape to tape all of it. So what you need, you can see this one is very roundish. So how to achieve this is what I want to show you guys now. So you can see your rough fabric that you can see here. All you are going to do is to try to bring out, like you want to tie it, try to bring it out like this. Try to tie it like this. You can see, make sure you are dragging it as you pull. Make sure you are pulling it like this. Make sure you are pulling it like this. Can see this pulling makes it to be strong for it to give you this nice and firm effect. So when ironing your bust, it does not press in. So make sure you pull like this. So you can see how I started it. Make sure you pull like this. Right here, it wants to rain. I don't know if they might take the light. That is how they normally do. I pray they don't take the light. So you pull like this. You can see me pulling very strong. Make sure you hold it very strong to pull. I'm trying to make it strong. Any fabric you are working with, make sure you pull. You can see me, you can see what I'm doing. It's very strong. I'm taking it like this. I'm just rounding it with my ball like this. So pay close attention to what I want to do. So I want to use this other fabric again. So just pay close attention to what I'm doing. I pull and I use it to cover my starting point, and you can see my hand coming this other side. I'm not focusing on only one place. I'm taking it around my ball like this, so you can see. So after everything, you see that this my fabric will go around the whole ball. So as I take like this, I pull. As I take, I pull. I'm making sure it goes round. I pull. You can see what I'm doing. I'm pulling. You can see this fabric is big. You can see what I'm doing. I'm not spreading it. I'm folding it like this. So it goes round. And I pull. I'm still pulling like this. So you can see. Let's go ahead to pull it like this. So you can see, not one place. I'm trying to take it, I'm moving it around. So you can see, make sure you pull. We are almost there, not there yet. Still need something, so let me make use of this one also. So that is exactly what you're going to do. Make sure you pull, make sure you're always pulling. So it gives your ball that nice and roundish shape. So you can see it is going all round. Just pay attention to the colors. You can see the colors is going around, trying to cover the white. can see I don't focus on only one area. I try to spread it and I draw. So I'm going to work with this also. So I believe this will be for the last. The way I can see, this is also big. This fabric is also big. This will be for the last. The way I can. So you can see, so you can see me pulling. So you can see me pulling just like this. So you can see what I'm trying to do. Pulling. I'm not focusing on one area. I'm moving it around. So you can see. Can see where it is still useful. The ball is now big. So you can see what we have achieved. This is it. So you just go ahead to press it. Press it like this. I'm trying to make it form my ball shape. So press it like this, press it, press it like this. Once you discover that it has formed that circular shape like this now, the circle, now what you do now is to get your masking tape, unfold it, or you unleash it, because the masking tape is ready for work now. Take it out like this. And you place it at that point here. So what you're going to do is to take your masking tape around. You're also pulling your masking tape, but don't pull it too hard so it does not cut off, but you're pulling it. So you can see what I'm doing here. You can see. Just like this, my masking tape. Just go ahead to scanty it before you decide to close all your all the areas that are left with your fabric open. So at this note, you can go ahead to cut it like this. Then press it down. You can see what I'm doing. You can see. I want to make it round, so go ahead and hit it. Forming the round shape as I hit like this, it's forming the round shape. So you can see the shape is forming out the round shape as I hit like this, it's forming out the round shape. You really need this to iron your posts. This is very important for your work to be neat. So go ahead to do it like this. And you apply your tape again. see what I'm doing. So you can see, covering those fabric, trying to cover those fabric until I will seal all these edges, all these holes that this fabric are showing. I will seal everything, so when somebody sees it, they will wonder what is inside, because they won't be able to see what is inside. See, so I have only these few holes remaining. Go ahead to trace it, locate those holes. I'm trying to find this hole. It might take a pass through. So it enters that hole. Another hole here. That's closed. So how will I go to achieve nothing of this whole thing? So I'll come like this. So all the holes have been closed. I'm still applying my masking tape. So you can see everywhere I can see you. You can go ahead to put much of it if you want. So you can see my ball is out. So with time, you can go ahead to replace it with new tape. Just the way I did this, put more tape. When it is old, all you need to do is to be replacing it with new tape when it is old. So that's what you will be doing. So you can see this one is even bigger than this one. So I have my three steps. But if you want a bigger voice, you need to do it more bigger than this one, because this is almost as this. I will give this to a friend of mine that requested for this. So I decided to shoot the video because I have been promising you guys on how to go about this. So this is the three steps which I have here. You can see how roundish it is. You can see it is very strong. Very strong. So when you place your bust on it, just go ahead to press. So you can make it big. You can make it any size you want, based on how you want to put it. So this is it. So I want to thank every one of you for coming, stopping by to learn. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful. And don't forget to share to your friends to also see on how to make their own boards for their work to be easy for them. So thank you, everyone. Stay safe and remain blessed.